There's something in the air inside the starshine. There's something in the air we'll never know. I can feel it take hold. Infected. They're calling on the land.
Brooklyn, New York, in a packed Barclays, we are here for the main event of Turmoil 321, and boss, our resident hacker, the leader of the Darknet Society, seemingly taking a break. He has proven that he can dig up some dirt and try and ruin people's lives with his hacking skills. Right now, he's here to remind everybody how dangerous he can be inside the ring.
Yeah, DNS out here showing how dangerous they can be by just using Google. Bunch of assholes trying to ruin the career, life, and legacy of Valkyrie. You see Valkyrie? You see a shitty agent too, by the way, Jack. That agent needs to be fired. He's a piece of garbage. No emotion.
Agreed.
No empathy for his client. Great representation, by the way, Valkyrie. Speaking of representation, we have one and only John Carter, Jake Allen, the wrestling man.
And there is often not any empathy, as we have seen throughout the careers of John Carter and Bash, and hell, even on this show, capital EMP, just to kick things off. There's no empathy anywhere around. And boss, we saw John Carter not too long ago in a main event against the OCW World Champion. Technically picked up a win here, although probably not the way he would have liked.
Yeah, he won by DQ because El Capitan Sonata was, as they say, a bitch coward. Social media is a buzzing. They called on champion a pussy, Jake. They say he's afraid of what you call the world's greatest knee. Ugh. But apparently he put enough of the fear in the heart of the opponent to use a chair. That's why his stupid ass got fined as well. But I digress. It's not about last week. It's not about his tainted victory. It's about John Carter versus Bash. The future versus the present. Ugh. Everyone, these are our current star, our new stars even, Jake Allen. What a time to be alive. I say that with sarcasm, but I mean it in a wholeheartedly wholesome way. John Carter on top. Ugh.
We can hear it in your voice, boss. Bash and John Carter have already jumped way up the ranks, especially you're talking about John Carter, a former light heavyweight champion. Obviously, one of the most decorated tag team competitors we have currently on an OCW roster, going right to the headlock. You saw the back of his jacket. He calls himself a technical genius. The H is not missing.
It's not. Oh, nice take. Look at it. He's going to good old-fashioned wrestling. About John Carter, a former light heavyweight champion. Bash is no slouch in the 2017, rather, hot dog eating championship. To that, Nathan's.
This inside the ring here in a Turmoil main event, certainly going to be a bigger challenge than a Nathan's Frank eating contest. And Bash, both of these men have challenged for the CCW World Championship before in their career. Bash, of course, much more recently came up short against B-17. You got to think that has fueled the fire that is lit under his ass right now.
Oh, Jesus.
Think about what all has happened between Bash and Pearl Valkyrie, as we talked about, and not even mentioning Samson Simpson, the number one contender for the tag team titles.
With Iceman, the Iceman have a shot at greatness at hard target. Bash probably has his dance card full. You never know it. John Carter looking to pave his way into the OCW championship come hella high. What's up?
Oh, and after last week, the attack by El Parca and his goon, and John Carter was the victim then. He is no victim right now. Back-to-back Northern Lights suplex puts Bash on the canvas. He is able to kick out at one, but that is an interesting point you bring up here, boss. John Carter, another main event here, adding more feathers to his cap and certainly looking to be the next challenger for the world title after Sheldon Trimbley has had his say.
And you know what? Bash is no slouch either. We said that before. Went up against a champion, came up short, but Bash is looking himself right now to get back into, like you would say, Jake Allen, pole positiones.
Oh. It's going to be need to walk in with a few poles if John Carter keeps turning the back like that. Fireman's carry, though, and it doesn't look like a guy like Bash would be more of a technical wrestler, but honestly, since joining the OCW ranks, that's kind of been his bread and butter.
Oh, he's going.
Seeing it on display right now.
Oh. He's a little more brawl style than wrestling, but he's going blow for blow with John Carter. But he's coming up a little right now. John Carter a little bit ahead, but Bash is trying to even that up immediately. This is, oh, wait a minute. Oh,
Thought he was trying to maybe toss him out. Got caught up. Took a little too long with John Carter, who immediately goes for the roll-up. Very smart. Very tactical.
I'll tell you this, Jason Sensation. You mentioned Bash, more of a brawler. I think it's the combination of that unique intuition that he has as a fighter and his formal wrestling training kind of reminds me a lot of Colin Locke.
Ooh, good.
Way that he has improved and mixes his styles up, and you're seeing it right now. It's not just offensive, but defensive for Bash as well.
That's a good throwback to the Colin Locke, former national champion, former tag champion. The owner of Lock and Key Storage. Wherever you're hiding, we miss you, brother. Oh, to the top. Goes Bash.
Right now, trouble. Bash. Ooh. Lucky that he didn't miss that boot to the jaw of John Carter. Carter took him upstairs, maybe for a superplex, and these two are going to continue to swing on one another. Big back elbow from Bash to get him back in control. And again, going back to the ground with the snapmare and a chop.
They're throwing ham bones and soup bones and neck bones and all turkey bones at each other. And now, look at that. Jesus Christ. Look at Bash. Look at the little technical from himself. He's a genius, Jesus. Now he's going to show you John Carter. He's a technical genius perhaps as well. Nice use of the legs.
Indian Deathlock trying to weaken the knees of John Carter. You already brought up the greatest knee of all time.
Ugh.
That is what he calls that running knee strike. And certainly would be a lot weaker if he can't take off of that left plant foot.
There you
John
go.
Carter once again going to the Northern Lights suplex. That is the third of the match.
No
after
bridge.
That counter. And Carter going to the middle rope.
With the fist drop.
Wow.
I think I saw a tooth, Jake Allen, a wrestling tooth from the wrestling man.
John Carter not trying to lose any teeth or really in this match, certainly. Into the corner goes Bash, and now maybe a measure of revenge. Oh, my God, he just dumped him off. No superplex at all, just dumping him unceremoniously to the floor. And here we go again, Nova Roselio.
There you go.
That is El Parca's muscle catching John Carter with a blindside. Bash has the referee distracted, and I hate to call that a smart move as Nova continues. Turn around, asshole!
Oh, the fix might be in on John Carter. El Parca's taking that loss, as we say, personally and heavily. And Nova got his ass whooped last week by Sheldon and John Carter. It's about a measure of revenge. Oh!
Boom! Bash fist dot bat! Yeah. After Jesus Nova Roselio's interference, one,
no
two,
way.
Three, Bash! Whoa, it is that simple, Jason Sensation. The 1-2-3 after the... After the power bomb on the outside, the fix certainly in. But did Bash have anything to do about this?
Who the hell knows? But you saw it, Jake Allen. That shoulder was up on three, and Greg is.
It's a company-wide conspiracy. But what do you know about this? Either way, Bash picking up a signature win in the main event of Turmoil 3-21, and
that's a huge for Bash. Oh, wait a minute.
Here's the beat. Not be done. Hold on. Opposite barricade is Bash getting in the face of the fans. The man who was formerly controlled by the worm, Samson Simpson, trying to fight back and instead gets thrown up against the pole.
You just had to find yourself a new friend. And you just had to make him feel important. You really thought John Carter would be your saving grace? Be the one to help you take me down? Me? You're more foolish than I could have imagined, Sheldon. This is what happens to those who interfere in my business and who try to take away me a more. A crime that cannot go unpunished. Johnny boy, you have Sheldon to thank for this. And Sheldon can watch on as I take away yet another promising star from OCW. So Sheldon, watch and regret that this is your goddamn fault.
Well, looks like the fix is in. Jake Allen, Sheldon trying to come outside and help. Hold it. Wait a minute.
Well, maybe not for long. Is Bash clearing the table? The fans here in Barclays know that familiar tune.
That's about the Valkyrie, baby.
Valkyrie has seen enough. We have Samson, John Carter, Sheldon in the ring. Nova, it is a Pier 6 brawl here at the end of Turmoil. El Parca, despite Valkyrie's interference, going back to John Carter inside the ring.
Getting a little confusing there. I don't think Valka's going to make it. Caught. Oh, Jesus Christ. God.
He's going to make him watch, boss. He's going to make him watch as he tries to dismantle John Carter. After what happened in the main event last week, or I should say after the main event, Sheldon helpless being held back.
Jesus. That'll knock your eyes orbital out. We have too many orbital injuries in OCW currently, Jake. It's a little bit of a mess.
You could see, there's a mess on the canvas right now. Sheldon, again, nothing to do but watch on.
God damn.
Big chair to the face of John Carter, and you can see the blood all over his midsection. Samson trying to fight back against Bash there up here on our announce table.
That beautiful distraction by Valkyrie. Got bombed.
Big DDT.
Was caught lacking, as you say, Jake Allen. Good God almighty. It's a very chaotic main event. Jesus. Anyway, we'll see you next week for Turbo the Go Home Show. Remember, on Saturday, 6:28. Jesus Christ. I got